I'm inspired by those stories to go after the newer treatments that offer some promise, some new mechanisms of action to treat disorders that don't get better. I'm Dr. Linda Carpenter. I'm chief of the Mood Disorders Program at Butler Hospital. I run the TMS clinic, and I'm also director of the Butler Neuromodulation Research Facility. I take care of patients with a variety of mood disorders and specialize in the treatment of depression that hasn't gotten better with standard treatments. It's important for me to get a sense of what's what and for the patient to understand, I am this person, this is the illness, I can be different from it, so I can get back to being myself again. And I think, so sort of call out those things, recognize them, identify them, and appreciate them as part of a brain illness is a really important step to help people to know what recovery is going to be like and what it's going to involve and what they should look and feel like at the end. You know, it's a rehabilitation process when you've been sick for a lot of years or severely ill, and particularly because it's a health problem that changes your thinking, it might be difficult to know what the goals are. You might not be able to engage in the treatment if you don't have belief that you are different than that illness and that you can become yourself again. The other thing that might help people know when it's time to get help is if others who know them, work with them, interact with them, care about them, comment to them. You know, if somebody checks in, you don't seem like yourself, or I've noticed you're not functioning the way you normally do, that's a good time for any of us to take a pause and say, am I just explaining this away? Am I able to correct it, or do I need some help? When they start to run out of options, they've been through everything that an expert can recommend, you know, what's left, what's next? Because that hopelessness can lead to real self-destruction and giving up and suicide. And so I think it's important to keep myself as well as my patients engaged in knowing what else we're working on, so that when this doesn't work, it's not the end of the line. There is more, and sometimes we have to be patient and wait for it to be available. We certainly have to keep working on getting these new treatments developed, but I think it's important for all of us.